So. Dear ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, guests and friends from the house, I'd like to welcome you to the Dortmund EU. I'm very happy that you decided to attend the third Smart Places conference today. This is not a matter of course, especially in times of the coronavirus. Fortunately, we in Dortmund can be very happy that there has not been a proven case of this disease yet. That is good for the people who live here, and today especially for the organization of this event, which Britta Lerch and Jenny Müller prepared with great commitment. At that point, thanks for your hard work. My special thanks also go to our international speakers and project partners who have made their way to the Dortmund EU today to reflect, to discuss, and get inspired by testimonies from innovative thinkers and benchmarking projects from around the world on how to make sense of digital for culture institutions and practitioners. I would also like to thank Creative Europe, Creative Europe Desk, and the City of Dortmund and everyone who contributes to the success of this special project. Today, we meet at the place where it all started. So at this point, let me tell you briefly something about this special building, which has a specific history. The Dortmund EU not only shapes the silhouette of a city as a landmark, it is also an impressive symbol of the structural change in the Ruhr region. The former brewery contains various institutions and has made a name for itself as a new type of contemporary culture center, embodying innovative practice at the intersection of art, research, cultural education, and creativity. The U, founded in 2010, is not a classical cultural institution or museum, but rather a place with diverse cultural and educational offers aiming to reach a multitude of different audience groups. In response to changing society and new audience behaviors, the Dortmund EU and many other European cultural institutions are turning towards digitization to become more accessible. However, they have to face fundamental challenges to becoming a digital-enabled institution. For us, the key questions to initiate the Smart Places project have been: how can we encourage citizens, audience and tourists, which only know us as a landmark in the city, to actually visit us? How can we engage more effectively with local communities from our neighborhood? How can digital help us to open up new avenues of change and interaction? To address these challenges and experiment with new approaches and digital tools, such as apps, extended reality, social media, but also to share experiences, cooperate on joint activities, and learn from each other, the Smart Places project was initiated by the Dortmund EU in 2014. For us, the collaboration with European partners and the continuous investment in experimental and cooperative projects were of particular importance. As a four-year-lasting European audience development project, Smart Places is funded by the Creative Europe Programme and the European Union. It is being delivered by a partnership of 8 cultural institutions and 2 universities from 7 European countries, coordinated by the Dortmund EU. We are very happy that we are able to work with many committed partners in the implementation of the project. At this point, I would like to name them again. Our partners are ZKM Karlsruhe, Van Abbe Museum Eindhoven in the Netherlands, Azcuna Centro A and Etopia in Spain, Musée de Picardie in Amiens, and the Liechtenstein National Museum. We are also happy about our academic partners, research and technology partner OLU, University of Applied Science in Finland, at the Birmingham Center for Media and Cultural Research. Today, we can rightly look back on the success of constructive cooperation. From June 2016 to May 2020, the partnership undertook more than 57 activities or experiments to develop new approaches to audience engagement, co-creation, and producing new creative works. With a diverse use of digital technology, social web tools, adaptive storytelling techniques, as well as joint exhibitions and on and offline activities, the partnering institutions learn to shape the inner digital transformation process they are going through. To succeed with the overall ambitions, the project also focused on change management and emphasizes the inclusion of cultural mediation, capacity building, and knowledge exchange. Across the 9 institutions, about 80 to 100 colleagues were involved in our work program over the last 4 years. We are proud that the project formed such strong connections among our partnering organizations, with former colleagues and team members joining us again today at this conference. This is the last conference out of 3 before the project will end in May. Therefore, there could be almost a cause for sadness today. But there is good news. Many personal and institutional connections were formed that will continue after the project ends. So we should be further happy and looking forward to an inspiring day which adopts the culture of sharing established during the project. Now, I wish everyone a pleasant stay in Dortmund and constructive discussions. Thank you for your kind attention and enjoy the conference. Now there's Arpai for you.
Hey. I had no idea I was so famous. So, good morning, lovely people. You have the pleasure of being welcomed twice. I had the honor of curating the conference today. So, welcome to our 3rd and final Smart Places conference. We are really very happy to have you here. Now, the theme of our conference is the human experience of engaging with digital. It came after reflecting on the journey that our project partners have been over the past 4 years. So we did develop many interesting digital tools, and we ran loads of activities that had a strong digital aspect. So if you ask me, did we innovate? I would say yes, in a conventional sense, because I feel the biggest change that has happened over the past 4 years has been in all of us. The way we think about and the way we relate to digital. It's a mix of excitement, hope, optimism, and because we are realistic, it's also a mix of fatigue. And you'll hear this story across the 4 conference tracks that are called identity, belonging, access, and acceptance. So who tells this story of our project? It could have just been us, the Smart Places partners on stage, because we are a pretty interesting bunch of people. And there are many interesting things that we can talk about for a very long time, but that would have been very self-centered, as it assumes that this journey that we've been on for the past 4 years is exclusive to us, because that's simply not the case. Everyone, all of you gathered here today, are somewhere on that journey of trying to make sense of digital, and that's why we hope you're here today. Now, in our project, with partners from 9 countries, we had the luxury that every success was immense, but every failure was also contextualized in different cultural contexts. And that's what we've tried to recreate today. Across the 4 tracks, we have the luxury of listening to multiple narratives of success and failures from practitioners around the world. We have a very fine, multidisciplinary group of really nice people who work in museums, the theater, publishing, broadcast, festivals, and my favorite, the circus. And of course, you'll hear from my Smart Places colleagues, but they're going to be doing what they do best, which is asking critical questions. And I felt that's what made our project really special. You can take a deeper dive into some of these themes that we discuss in our tracks in the workshops later today, And if it all gets a little bit too much, we planned a little surprise. Dorothy, can you just wave your hands? Dorothy is going to run a little surprise for you at 3:30 in the afternoon. Finally, a special word of thanks to a few colleagues who've been working behind the scenes to make today possible, but you won't see them on stage today. So Hester Chersonius, our communications guru, where is she? Is she here somewhere? Please, there she is. She shared the story of this conference as we've been developing it real time through our newsletters and our social channels. And of course, our superhero, event producer Jenny Mueller. Hand up, please. Who I know for a fact has had many, many sleepless nights so that you can enjoy today. And also, I think we are being live streamed. Where's the camera? Hello to Maite Arbaras in Bilbao. She's been doing great work behind the scenes. Just a round of applause for her as well, please. So I hope this day sparks many conversations that become interesting projects. And with that, I hand you over to our wonderful MC, Corey Moore. Thank you.
Hello. Hi. Hi, everybody. Welcome. Thank you very much, Alpay. It's very exciting. I'm going to try and come down a little bit to make sure I'm not too loud. We have a really jam-packed day today with over 20 speakers, international speakers, and as Alpay alluded to, a couple of surprises as well. But to get us into the mood for a creative and inspiring day, I think it would be lovely if we started by introducing Caroline Lavelle.